Hi everyone, welcome back. If you do not know, my name is Devon. Here on my channel, I cover all things beauty. That includes makeup, fragrance, and design here and there. If you think that is something you'll be interested in, then I hope you stay and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to click the notification bell so you're notified every week when I upload. And in today's video, I am super excited to be talking about the brand new Kayali Vanilla Candy Rock Sugar, you guys. Yes, I got my hands on the glitched release and I'm so excited to be doing a first impressions with you guys, as well as comparing it to a couple other fragrances that you guys have said that it's supposed to be similar to. So if you guys want to hear my thoughts and first impressions on this brand new fragrance, then just keep watching. You guys, when I say I am excited, I am excited. I have had a picture of a leaked packaging of this in my phone for months. If I can find it, I will post it, but I have had this in my phone for months waiting for Mona to drop this fragrance. I was so excited. Anything vanilla, I am here for. But this is her. She literally just arrived 20 minutes ago. The original date for this is supposed to be May 2nd. That is when this is going to be releasing. But as you can see, some people have already been talking about it. I have seen it on different social platforms, what they are saying this is compared to. So I have a bunch of the fragrances with me and we're gonna go ahead and unbox her and talk about her. So this is the packaging. It's just a plain Kayali white box, but it has holographics on the side. I did get the 1.7 fluid ounce. This retails for $89. Y'all, the packaging on here, oh my God. Woo, look at that. It is this beautiful iridescent purpley pink, which is why I did my makeup the way that I did today. I wanted to add eyeshadow to match this packaging and it is gorgeous. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you the key notes in here. They are candied pear, sweet violet, bubble gum, white caramel, rock sugar, and vanilla cream. And obviously the key notes are on the back as well. She's so beautiful. So okay, we're gonna go ahead and first impression sniff her and see what we think. All right. Oh, it's so sweet. Okay. I'm kind of getting a couple of comparisons, like what people were saying. Okay. This is a yes for me. I can already tell you this is a yes. I am about to spray this on my skin, but this is an absolute yes. It smells so pretty. Now, again, first impressions, obviously. So this will not be a wear test or anything like that. You already know the longevity on Kayali fragrances are not always the best, but I don't mind. I overspray, I layer, and I am okay with that. If you are not, be cautious, be wary. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I am going to spray this on my hand as well because I want to just, you know, see how it smells on my skin versus the paper. Y'all, this packaging is gorgeous. Like, all right. So a lot of people are saying they get like this sweet candied pear. I kind of get that. I get that. Definitely something very, very sweet. I definitely get some sort of bubblegum accord type of note in here. It's similar to some things that I can think of off the top of my head, but I don't know if they're exact. Like I said, I pulled out a couple fragrances so I can sniff them. Also tell you if they are very similar if you have something in your collection. But yeah, this is pretty. It's super, super sweet. I get a hint of bubblegum, but it's not like a full-blown bubblegum fragrance like I thought it was going to be. But it is very, very sweet, candy-like. I definitely get some sugar in here. I'm definitely starting to get vanilla. The bubblegum note doesn't last in here. I thought, like, I still smell it, but it's definitely more in the background. If you know what, like, bubblegum fragrances smell like, you know it's kind of like a sweet powdered sugar type of fragrance. And I get that, but it's kind of going into the background. I get a lot of sweetness. I feel like I get, like, really sugary, powdery sweetness. I definitely get a heavy vanilla fragrance in here. And the opening has a really sweet candied pear type of fragrance. Now, in saying that, I pulled out a couple fragrances that people are saying this is in remnants of. So first of all, we pulled out the Moschino Toy 2 Bubblegum. I mean, the packaging is like, they're gorgeous together. This is the first thing I thought of when I seen a bubblegum note, but is this exactly like that? It's not. Yeah, this is more like sweet, airy, sort of a fresh but bubblegum like fragrance. This one, I feel like I smell a lot of the bubblegum in there. This one, I feel like the bubblegum lasts a long time. Like, I get bubblegum sweetness out of this. Whereas I feel like the Kayali, I don't. Yes, it's bubblegum. Yes, it's sweet. But I feel like this one is a little bit more like gum, but like a fresh bubblegum. So are these the exact same? They're not. Something else that I was seeing is that a lot of people were saying it remind them of Vanilla 28, like the dry down on here. I'm going ahead and spray her. Vanilla 28 is so good. It's such a beautiful, sweet, brown, sugared type of fragrance. I do feel like it has a similar like vanilla feel in here, but it is not exact. Yeah, they are different, but I do feel like you get that Kayali Vanilla 28 DNA. Like, you get that, but it's not as brown sugar sweet, if that makes sense. Another fragrance that everyone was comparing it to was the Kayali Silk Santal, the wedding set, because this also has a similar feel to Vanilla 28, but I feel like, yeah, I feel like they have a little bit of a similar DNA. When I was looking on the Kayali site, it said something about having like a Kayali's signature DNA in this fragrance, and I feel like it's very similar to Vanilla 28, Silk Santal, and this one. Like, they have a similarity to them, but they're not the exact same. This one is still so much more sweeter. Yeah, I'm sorry, my video had cut off, but they're a little bit different, but you can tell they are in the same family. All right, now the next fragrance that this is getting compared to a lot is going to be Jean Paul Gaultier La Belle. A lot of people are comparing this to the Kayali and saying that they are similar. And I think it's because they both have like vanilla pear notes in here. I don't think they're the same, but it's something similar in here. I think it's the pear note in both of these that are making them smell very, very similar. La Belle is definitely way stronger, heavier, a little bit more syrupy, have similarities. Like, I can see that. Even with them drying down, you can smell a difference in them. I just think the opening is very similar to one another. So a couple other fragrances I have that I thought were going to be similar was Bath & Body Works Bubblegum Pop. I can tell you now, it's not. This one is more remnants to the Moschino Toy 2 Bubblegum. It has more of that in here, but this one is a little bit more bubblegummy citrus. It doesn't really have a vanilla base to ground it. It's just really, really citrusy and sweet and smells like sweet bubblegum. So they definitely are not the same, but you can probably pair these together to pull more of that intense bubblegum citrusness from here into here. I think you can do that. And then the next body spray I wanted to compare it to was Pink, and this is from the Pop Jelly Collection, and it's Vanilla and Dreamy. This one has Sweet Pear, Pink Jasmine, and Bubblegum Pop. This to me is similar. It has this pear note in here. just like the Kayali, as well as the bubblegum note in here. I mean, it's definitely more of a body spray form. I know a lot of people say Kayali's fragrances are like body splashes. I don't really have a problem with them. Layer, I can reapply. I don't have a problem with that. So these two do have a similar feel. I think these body sprays will all pair beautifully with this. Now I do have, let's see, I have this fragrance. It is a silky perfume oil, and this is from Sugar Milk Co. I used to love purchasing from them. I haven't purchased from them in a while. This is Princess Bubblegum, and I actually used to wear this with my Moschino Toy 2 bubblegum, but this one is more citrus. This has a very sweet bubblegum note, but it's very, very citrusy. It kind of reminds me of this, but in like an oil form. It has some similarities to it. And then the very last fragrance I have is by Le Monde Gourmand, and this is Le Bubble Pop, and this also has a bubblegum note in here, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, this has a bubblegum note in here too. The opening, definitely, like the bubblegum is so similar to this. I feel like when everybody does bubblegum, it's like a pink powdery bubblegum. I feel like that's what you think of when you smell bubblegum. No other colors, no other flavors. It's a pink bubblegum. And I feel like it is very, very similar to this as well. But again, the dry down is different. So I am back. I had to take a quick 30-minute break because I wanted to spray all these fragrances on my body and see if any of them really, really smelled like the vanilla candy rock sugar, right? I will say that there are some similarities. I feel like the opening the most to me smells like Label. Like I feel like they have a very, very similar opening, and it's probably that vanilla pear combo in here that makes them smell similar. But on the dry down, at least to my nose, they don't smell alike on dry down, but on opening, on first opening, they do smell very similar. Okay. Now, as far as Silk Santal, when I was smelling them side by side on the papers, I was thinking like, okay, these two smell alike somewhat. I feel like on the dry down, they don't. They smell very, very different dried down. A little bit more like woody, but still very sweet and vanilla. So I love Silk Santal. It's one of my favorite fragrances from the House of Kayali. Mona, you need to bring that back if you're watching this. Bring it back. We need that. But she smells so, so pretty. So again, they have slight similarities to them. They are not exact, and they do not smell the same on dry down. Now, Vanilla 28 to me smells the most similar on the dry down. It's not exact, but it's definitely very similar. And again, it's just that Kayali DNA, that vanilla in there, that this one to me is like way sweeter, more sweeter brown sugar syrupy, where this one is definitely more powdered candy sweet. Like it's definitely a candy sweet, but they do have a very, very similar dry down. We like 70% similar on the dry down DNA. Is this an exact dupe for anything in my collection? No, it is not. But could I come up with a similar fragrance combo in here? I absolutely could, especially since I have so many sweet bubblegummy type of fragrances. Any of these bubblegum fragrances from your collection, you can pair with any of these vanilla type of fragrances and you will definitely get a very similar feel. So do I think you guys need this? If you have all of these in your collection, I don't. But do I need this in my collection? I do. Like I said, I am a Kayali fan and of Mona as well. I love her fragrances. They always do me right with my body chemistry. They work so well. I always get compliments on my Kayali fragrances. No matter what people say about the longevity or them not lasting, I always get compliments on my Kayali fragrances. I really enjoy this one. I think it's so pretty. I think this is going to be absolutely perfect for spring and summertime. Like this is not overly too like juvenile. I love sweet scents. I always have sweets, and vanillas are like my favorite type of DNA in fragrances. So I absolutely love this, but this is not going to be for everyone. If you love super thick, heavy, long lasting, like sexy fragrances, this is not going to be for you. If you don't mind that this is not going to radiate throughout, like you walk in a room, everybody probably is not gonna smell this because it is a little bit on the lighter side. Can I smell it? Yes. And I'm going to layer the mess out of this so other people can smell it. Actually, I'm going to wear this tonight. When I am done filming today, I'm going to shower and I'm going to put this on tonight. I love this one and I enjoy it. It is very, very beautiful. I think Mona always knocks it out the park with her fragrances. I feel like a lot of her fragrances are different. A lot of them are different than what we get from the everyday fragrance community. A lot of them, but not all of them. Like this one is going to do so good. Like it's already hyped up as it is. People are trying to get their hands on it. So yeah, I think she did an amazing job with this and I'm so happy about it. So yeah, those are my thoughts. Comment down below if you guys plan on picking this up or if you already have it, because like I said, they had a glitch in their system, so a lot of people was able to purchase the fragrances and a lot of people were not. But this will release on May 2nd. So if you are interested, don't forget to pick it up. So yeah, that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching and I will see you in another video. Bye.